Does vinegar help lower blood sugar? And if it does, what role should vinegar play in the management of diabetes? Should people with diabetes take vinegar regularly for blood sugar control? Hi, I'm Dr. Chan. I am a medical doctor from Singapore. My work and my passion is in training and coaching people in the area of lifestyle modification for the prevention and management of chronic diseases. The videos I put out on this channel are focused on providing information on lifestyle habits and the chronic diseases such as diabetes, hypertension, and other chronic diseases that are impacted and modifiable by lifestyle change. And through that, I hope to inspire more people to start taking action to improve and unlock the power of their lifestyle habits as medicine in combating these lifestyle modifiable chronic diseases. Today, I shall tackle these two questions. Does vinegar help lower blood sugar? Can adding vinegar to meals help people with diabetes reduce blood sugar spikes after meals? And if it does, then what role should or can vinegar play in the diets of people with diabetes? How should people with diabetes add vinegar to their diets? Let's start with what medical science knows and says about this topic. And if you know where to look, we can actually find many medical studies on this. For example, these two studies done on people with diabetes as well as people with insulin resistance. This study and this study. And they found that vinegar, when taken together with high GI, high carbohydrate meals, does help people with diabetes reduce post-meal blood sugar spikes. And let me also show you these two other studies done on people without diabetes. This study and this study. In these latter two studies, they found that vinegar, when taken at meal times with carbohydrates-rich meals, can help to some extent reduce the blood sugar spikes post-meal, even in healthy adults without diabetes. There are many such studies done on the impact of vinegar on blood sugar. I shared these four studies merely to highlight what medical science already know about vinegar's blood sugar lowering potential, but I do not intend to go into a detailed analysis of each of these studies in this video. For those of you who are familiar with reading and interpreting medical studies, I have links to these studies in my blog post on this, link in the show notes below. But for those of you who intend to go read the studies, I just want to highlight and to remind you the things to note when interpreting medical research findings, such as whether the findings were statistically significant and how the studies were designed and what limitations that study design would put on the interpretations on the findings. Don't just take the headlines of any research articles and take away incomplete or worse, incorrect interpretations. So, back to this question that we set out to tackle in this video today. Does vinegar help lower blood sugar? Perhaps it would be useful to fine-tune this question a little further to make it more specific. Let's focus the question on, does vinegar help lower blood sugar for people with diabetes? And to make it even more specific, does vinegar help reduce post-meal blood sugar spikes for people with diabetes? And from the various medical research that one can find that studied this, the answer is, yes, it does. To some degree, to some extent at least. Especially for people with diabetes or insulin resistance when taking high GI, high carb meals. That is, vinegar, when added to foods or taken at meal times, may help to some degree to blunt the blood sugar spikes from high GI, high carb, starch-rich meals. And this effect was seen in both people with diabetes as well as healthy people without diabetes. But before we run away with this information and use it inappropriately, let me put a caveat and caution to how we should, and more importantly, how we should not be using this information about this blood sugar lowering potential of vinegar. Firstly, even though vinegar has been found in some studies to help lower blood sugar spikes after meals, adding vinegar to one's diet should not and cannot be the only or the main thing that one does to one's diet for better blood sugar control. We must always holistically review and improve all aspects of one's diet that impact blood sugar control. And we must also tackle all aspects of lifestyle for holistic and optimal diabetes management. Secondly, And importantly, never stop or reduce your diabetes medications on your own. Please consult and work closely with your doctor. My suggestion on how we should and can make use of this information about vinegar's potential to lower blood sugar is this. Even without diving deep to study in detail the basic science of vinegar's impact on our body's physiology and studying in detail all the available medical research and clinical studies on the impact of the intake of vinegar at meal times on post-meal blood sugar spike, unless you have certain medical conditions where your doctor or dietitian had advised you to avoid or be careful with your intake of vinegar, it is not a bad idea to experiment and explore ways to include vinegar into our recipes and foods. If a common condiment that had been used widely for centuries around the world across different cultures and cuisines may help lower blood sugar spike post-meal, why not? Especially if it is easily accessible, very affordable, and just as importantly, makes food yummy and enjoyable. Why not? So go ahead and explore new ways to incorporate vinegar into your recipes when you're cooking at home or when you're eating out, if appropriate or possible. Go ahead and ask for some vinegar to add to your food, especially when you're having high GI, high glycemic index, high carbohydrate, starch-rich meals. Just like the Japanese do when they have sushi rice, or in certain Mediterranean cuisines, balsamic vinegar is often offered together with the bread basket. Or here in Singapore, where I'm from, we often add black vinegar to one of Singaporeans' favorite hawker foods, the bak chor mee, or minced pork noodles. Although the black vinegar used in this dish is often with sugar added, which is not ideal. Even though we can find medical studies that suggest that having vinegar at meal times can help reduce, to some extent at least, the degree of blood sugar spike post-meal, I do not recommend taking vinegar supplements in the form of pills. And I will also caution against taking concentrated or excessive amounts of vinegar. If your doctor and medical team had advised you to avoid or reduce the intake of vinegar for whatever medical conditions that you may have, you should comply with that advice. Also, don't let this information of vinegar being potentially helpful in lowering blood sugar be a distraction to you in terms of what you need to do to change and improve all aspects of your dietary habits to holistically and optimally combat diabetes. I have a video on the three mistakes that people with diabetes make when it comes to the use of vinegar in reducing blood sugar. It is on my other YouTube channel where I post my longer podcast videos where I will spend more time sharing and coaching. I suggest you go watch it after this, link in the show notes below. And here are the links to my other lifestyle habits as medicine content. Links are also in the show notes below. I hope you have found this video useful. Let's unlock the power of habits as medicine to prevent and combat diabetes and other lifestyle-related chronic diseases. Take care.